Hi guys, I'm Juliana with the Zakim Center, and this is Gentle Yoga Flow. So we're gonna be using a couple of props. We're gonna be using some blocks, perhaps some blankets if you need more support under your head or under your knees, and a strap. If you don't have a strap, it could be a towel, a belt, or scarf, something that you can loop around your foot. So let's get started. Let's move to the mat. And you're gonna find a way that supports you. Every week we change a little bit what we're working on. This week we're focusing a little bit more on hip opening and grounding poses. So we're gonna take the blocks the way we normally do, with one block under the shoulder blade, the other one under the head. Now, if the block feels a little too stiff, you can also take a blanket and roll it up. And when you roll it up like a little tiny burrito, you can put that for your shoulder blades if that feels better for you. You can also put a blanket a different height under your head as well, if that works for you as well. So allowing your body to come back, I'm gonna let the shoulder blades be supported here. I'm gonna adjust it so my shoulders are actually off the block. And then I'm gonna traction the back of my skull and drop it back down. Holding that block right under your head so you can feel that again, your chin slightly drops and then the back of the skull really lengthens. And I'm gonna allow the arms to open out to the side. The backs of the hands are supported, elbows are supported. And you can stay here with your feet perhaps a little bit wider if you need more support for the lower back, letting the knees knock in. Or today, if you're feeling that you wanna start to open into your hips right away a little bit more, soles of the feet together, knees out to the side. And again, this is one of those blankets or pillows might come in handy. And you can adjust them under your knees so your knees have a little bit more support and release here. So you can start to let go without too much effort. And then allow the backs of your hands again to fall open. The heart is open. Take a nice deep breath through your nose and a big sigh through the mouth. Let it go. Empty it out. Inhaling through the nose. Big sigh through the mouth. Letting go of tension, of stress, of drama, of fear, anxiety. Let it all wash away. Again, take a nice deep breath through the nose, breathing in calm and peace. And as you exhale, sigh it out, letting go of all that stale air, letting your body start to settle in. And when you close the eyes, you can start to draw the awareness a little bit more inwards. It's one of the eight limbs of yoga, pratyahara, withdrawing of senses. And so you can start to notice where your body is right now. And perhaps starting from that contact of the skin with the mat, maybe the blocks, the blankets. With your clothes. And deepening into your core, starting to notice where else you can let go. And soften the muscles in the forehead. Start to relax the jaw. Perhaps a little movement of the jaw to help to unclench. Maybe a big yawn. Letting the tongue move around. And releasing through your shoulders. Your elbows. The fingertips. And feeling the heart wide open. Shoulder blades supported so you can let go completely. Feeling open to new possibilities. Positive things to come. And allowing the belly to feel soft. And the hips to feel heavy. Grounding, releasing again. Legs, knees, all the way down to your toes. As you find your body fully supported, relaxed and safe. Start to deepen the awareness to the breath. So in the stillness of the body, there's still movement of the breath. And you might start to notice the rising and fall of the belly. You can even allow one hand to rest there. Starting to notice the short pauses between your inhalation and your exhalation. Perhaps noticing the breath getting longer, deeper, smoother. And noticing how the mind starts to quiet down, calming, most likely quieter than when you started. So this simple exercise and practice of bringing the awareness to the breath, it's the type of mindfulness meditation where the mindfulness, the awareness, is the breath. And whenever you get distracted, which will happen, you can just pick up where you started, just come back to your breath. Over and over again, it's a practice. And noticing how that will help you to find a little bit more quiet between, a little bit more pause between the thoughts, I should say, a little bit more quiet of the mind. And in this pause, you can take that deeper breath. And that deeper breath, you can make better decisions, react better, and feel better. So whenever you feel there's too much going on, practicing coming back to your breath to help to find that yogic state of mind, you find a little bit more quiet and peace. Allow your other hand to rest over your heart. And then we're going to stack one hand on top of the other. And as you inhale, breathe in the gratitude of being here today, of taking time from your busy schedule to take care of yourself with kindness, curiosity, always room for exploration, and no judgment, no right or wrong, but what feels good. And then setting up the intention for your practice. As you breathe in kind thoughts and positive energy, what is your heart's deepest longing? Those kind thoughts to yourself, to a loved one, or somebody in need. And with your next exhale, releasing your hands. Let your feet stay firm onto the earth. Let your knees point straight up to the sky. And when you're ready, inhale, let your fingertips start to reach up. And as you exhale, start to reach your arms back, soften through your elbows, and sweep the arms along the side of the body down to your feet. We're going to circle those arms again, inhaling forward and up. And exhale, you're going to start to reach back, soften through the elbows, and then sweep them again. Great job. Inhale, forward and up. Going to your own range of motion, exhale, reaching them back. And next time the arms are to the side, stay there. So the backs of your hands stay on the floor and you feel the heart opening. Take a nice deep breath into your heart. And with your next exhale, start to close your elbows parallel to each other. As you inhale, open the heart. And as you exhale, you close parallel to each other once again. And then perhaps inhale, opening. And next time you exhale, you close, maybe locking the fingers here and taking the hands behind the head. Now support your head like a little hammock for your head, like a basket here. Let your elbows point straight up to the sky. And you might start to feel a little bit more onto the chest, onto the back, and you can even massage it here. So if you have the block, it might feel a little edgy, but if you have the blanket, maybe you go a little deeper. You can take the elbows a little bit up. Maybe the head starts to soften. Now I'm going to add something different here. I'm going to start to bring the soles of the feet together and knees out to the side. And with the next exhale, I'm going to press into the heels and take the elbows up, pull belly in. And then as you inhale, you relax. As you exhale, start to feel the elbows pointing up, pull belly in. And then relax. Now you can stay here with the feet on the floor, knees out. Or as you exhale, maybe next time you pick up your feet up as well and then down. Again, this might feel too much. You can always stay with the feet onto the floor and knees up. Or you can start to press those heels into each other and start to pick up the knees as well. This is going to be your last one. As you exhale, come up, open your legs like a little frog. And you might feel, again, it might be a little too much for the core or your lower back. And you can stay with the feet back down. You're going to reach your hands out to the front and you're going to reach it out for four and three and two and one. Just bring the hands on the outside of your knees. Great job. And from here, start to roll yourself over to one side so you can come off of that block. Take the block or blankets or bolsters out of the way. And you're finding yourself onto your mat and just releasing it here completely. Capping your knees with your hands, start to circle it in one direction, massaging your lower back and circle it the other way. Right away, if you feel that you want to have that blanket under your head, you can just move it behind your head back there. I'm just gonna keep mine off, but you can always choose to bring it in. Then dropping your left foot to the floor, keep your right knee into your chest, slide your right hand behind the thigh and start to kick your right leg up and down a couple of times. And you start to get into the hamstring, into the knee joint, the back of the leg. We're going to hold that right leg up and you're going to point and flex and roll your ankle a couple of times. Point, flex, and roll it the other way. Start to get a little bit more ankle mobility, point, flex, and roll the ankle. Nice. I'm starting to push the thigh into the hand into the thigh. And right away, if you feel that feels too much extension, you can always take your strap here and put it behind the thigh to give a little bit more length for your arms, right? That's what the strap is for. And with your next exhale, we're going to bend that knee a lot. We're coming into a half happy baby. Again, focusing a little bit more opening of the hips and grounding poses. We're going to take that strap onto the foot and we're going to start to pump up, bending the knee, coming closer to your shoulder and pumping back up. Start to get more into the groin, into the belly. And we're going to hold both ends of the strap with the right hand, right knee is bent, and we're going to let it sway in and out. Half happy baby. Now, rocking of the pelvis is very soothing to the nervous system, rocking of the body itself. It's like when you put a baby in a rocking chair, right, or in the car seat, and as soon as it starts moving and rocking, fall asleep, right? It's that connection with the parasympathetic nervous system, the rest and digest. We're going to open that right leg out to the right. Now, again, you're going to use your elbow perhaps to have, it's like a kickstand, or if you need a block or something under that hip to open. And your hips most likely are going to start to turn over to the right. So to counterbalance, stay in the blade of your left foot and let your left knee splay a little bit more to the left, or bringing your left hand to your left hip so you can keep your hips level. And as you exhale, firm into the left foot, left knee up, right leg starts to come up. We're going to switch the hands here. And now bending the knee a little bit into the chest. And as you exhale, you're going to press your heel and turn your toes slightly to the left. Bend the knee a little bit and press and get it a little bit more to the left. Getting IT band. Beautiful. And now from here, as you exhale, we're going to cross and bring in that ankle over the thigh. Start to find your figure four, right knee moving away, getting into the right glutes, outer hips. You can stay there or you can pick up your left foot and start to bring that left knee in. And if you need, you can take a strap or your hands between the triangle of your legs and behind your left thigh. And the more you bring that left knee in and the more the right knee and shin more parallel to the chest, the deeper you're going to feel it under your right glutes. It's all having room to roll, to soften. I'm going to keep this figure four shape and drop things over to the left. Now, again, if this doesn't work for your hips, you can always stack your knees or keep the knees crossed, right? You might be able to hold onto that right ankle with the left hand, and the right arm might reach back, and you can start to sway the head a little side to side. Start to release into the neck and to the shoulders. Take a nice deep breath in. And with your next exhale, head to the center, knees to the center, uncross your legs. Give them a hug, a rock. So we're going to repeat the same onto the other side. We're going to drop the right foot, left knee into the chest, hold behind, and you start to kick your left leg up and down a couple times. Getting into the knee, into the hamstrings, and getting into the ankles and toes as we start to point, flex, and roll the ankle. And then you point, flex, and roll it the other way. Couple more. Nice. And then from here, as you kind of pushing it out, you start to bend into that knee a little bit more. We're going to use the strap over the foot for that half happy baby as we start to pump that knee down and up. Come in closer to the shoulder and back up. Down and up, adding a little bit more flow. Bend the knee. Hold it here and let it sway in and out. Half happy baby. Again, it's a great pose to help with digestion, constipation. Also helps with the shift of the flow of the immune system down the legs. And we're gonna take the leg, left leg out to the left. Now, again, your hips might start to sway to the left. So take your right hand to your right hip, ground it there, knee to the right, maybe blade of the foot to counterbalance a little bit more. Again, this is your practice. There's really no right or wrong at what feels good, and you can always modify. And if you don't know what to do, you can always put there on the chat. I keep it open. And then we're going to take that leg back up, switching the hand, start to bend the knee and pressing the heel, slightly pigeon toe your toes to the right, bend and press the heel and pigeon toe your toes to the right. So you're getting a little bit more on your IT band. Hold it there. And with your next exhale, we're going to cross that ankle over the thigh, figure four. So starting to adjust, maybe staying with the knee, foot on the floor, or maybe picking up that leg, the foot, and grabbing behind the right thigh. Noticing as that chin comes more parallel and your left knee moving away from you, can even use your elbow here to push it out. It becomes more intense, right? So you can choose what feels good, how much you need, rolling the ankle, a little rocking of the body. Take a nice deep breath in. And with your next exhale, we're going to drop everything over to the right. And I'm going to take that blanket out of the way. And again, you can always put, stack the knees or even one knee on top of the other, right? Crossing them. Let the gaze and shoulder open to the left. And you start to breathe a little bit more into that left side. The head might sway a little side to side. And you take a nice deep breath in. And a big exhale, you come back to the center once again. Give your knees one more hug here. And just noticing again the sensations in the hips and the legs. And we're going to turn it around onto our belly. Take your time here to roll down. And we're going to come on what we call crocodile, which again is another very grounding pose, which you support your forehead down. Now, some of you might use that edge of the blanket to bring it under your forehead so you don't smash your nose down onto the floor. There's a pressure point on your third eye that's very soothing to the nervous system, maybe a gentle massage there. Now you can stay here in your crocodile, or you can start to bend your, I'm going to mirror you, so your left knee out to the left. And start to feel the hips grounding a little bit more. Perhaps the right leg goes up to the sky like a little cattail. And there's a little tick-tock here, side to side. I'm just noticing. Release it back down. And if you want a little bit more intensity, start to take your elbows in and pull yourself into a sphinx, opening the heart. And as you exhale, slide that leg back. Feel a little opening into your heart here. And as you exhale, let your elbows sway out to the side, ground to your forehead once again. And as you start to move your hips a little side to side, this time it's the right knee that goes over to the right. Look, a little hockey stick. Start to feel your right hip in a groin opening, and perhaps your left leg goes up. Like a little cat tail, it goes side to side. And maybe noticing the sensations here, one leg is opening the groin, the other one a little bit more of the quadriceps. And with your next exhale, slowly allow that leg to go down and start to slide your hands forward and pull your chest through the gate of your arms. And as you exhale, you're going to slide that leg as well. And continue to relax your head here down. And trying to keep the length of the crown of the head forward, start to slide your elbows to the side. Slide the hands along the side of the mat. Tent the fingers and roll the heads of the shoulders up and back and squeeze your elbows. Feel from the crown of the head reaching forward and the tops of your feet pressing into the floor, engaging your kneecaps. Try to get long, like if you're plugging with your toes to the back wall, and then release. And once again, roll the heads of the shoulders back, squeeze the elbows, keep the gaze down, chin down. So it's about length. The spine loves length, so there's no pressure into the lower back. And then as you exhale, you soften. Start to take your hands closer to your shoulders, push yourself up into a tabletop. And allowing the knees to come under your hips and start to sway your body a little side to side. Maybe the head will soften a little side to side, right? You can choose here. Start to take the hands over to the right a little bit more, pushing the hips more to the left. Noticing the sensations under the armpit, the side. And then taking the hands back to the center and to the other side. Notice the sensations here. Little sway of the hips and the body. Beautiful. And come back to the center. Take your time tenting the fingers and perhaps locating where your blocks are. So my blocks are up here onto the front, kind of under my mat. You just want to just have them slightly ahead of you so you know where they are. All right. So from here, we're going to start to add a little cat and cow kriya, opening the chest forward. And as you exhale, start to dome into your back a little bit more. So dropping that tail. Now as you inhale, open the heart, and instead of dumping into the lower back, pull the belly in. So you have a little bit of that cat tail, but you have the opening of the heart of your cow. And that's where you want to stay, keeping a little bit more neutral spine. The gaze is down to the floor. And then we're going to let the left leg go back. And you start to pump that left heel, toes back, getting more into the calves, the toes, the ankles. And perhaps you stay here. And you can stay on your hands or on your fist, depending on how you feel. And then your right hand's going to go forward, right thumb goes up. Like you're going to shake somebody's hand. And again, when you pull it back, lift that leg and don't dump into the back. Pull belly in and engage. With your next exhale, elbows and knees starts to come closer together. Inhale, you reach. And perhaps you take your elbow to the side, the knee to the side, just for fun. Maybe creating a little bit more balance and stability. And you're going to take that hand down. Keep the knee to the side. And we're going to circle that knee a couple of times, really loosening up into the hips. And taking that knee out to the side, extend that leg and move your hips back and forth. Once again, working on the inner leg. And continue to breathe, noticing the sensations of your flow here. We're going to keep that left hand a little bit more forward. Right arm is going to go up. Follow your hand as you thread the needle and slide your shoulder under. Can you feel a little bit more opening into the back, into the thoracic spine? Your left fingertips can come to the floor and push and revolve that chest more. If you need to put a blanket or a pillow under your head or your shoulder, you can always add that for extra support. With your next exhale, release and slide that shoulder from under. And taking that leg behind you, pivot that foot behind. Beautiful. Now from here, onto your fingertips, take your hand to your hip, and inhale, roll the shoulders up and back. And finding a little bit more opening. Maybe that arm will start to go a little further up and extend. And as you exhale, slowly bring it all the way back down. Nicely done. A little cat and cow here. And start to opening the heart. I'm just going to turn it around so I don't turn my back to you. And this time it's going to be the right foot that goes back and you start to pump. Start to feel that sensation on the back of the leg, the toes, the ankles, the heel. And we're going to stay here, engage in the core. Stay firm on your right hand. And your left fingertips are going to start to go up. Pull belly in. Again, try not to dump. Maybe the toes will just barely lift from the floor. With your next exhale, maybe bringing the elbows and knees a little closer together. Now, again, you can always challenge your balance by trying to take the elbow to the side, the knee to the side, like a little fire hydrant. Inhaling. And next time it comes to the side, drop that hand down and circle that knee, keeping that 90 degree angle. So really loosening up into the hips. Next time the knee is out to the side, extend the leg. And starting to do a little movement of the hips back. And again, it could be very small. It's gonna get a little bit more into that inner leg, the kidney line, the yin meridian here. And we're gonna stay, walk the right hand maybe an inch or two forward, left arm goes up, follow your hand as you exhale, thread the needle, the back of your arm, hand slides, shoulders comes down. And you start to find a little bit more of a twist. You can push into the hand to revolve, or you can stay here, take one more breath in. As you exhale, slowly release. Take your hands down. Foot's going to step behind you. And taking that hand onto your hips, maybe you pivot slightly that foot back so you can find a little bit more of a tripod. Start to open into the hips. Hand can stay on the hips. You can start to move up. Maybe it opens behind you. And then slowly release it down. Again, no right or wrong. You can always explore. When you bring it down, finding your cat and cow once again. Eventually, we're gonna drop back onto our heels into a child's pose. Let your knees perhaps go a little bit wider and toes can come in. Now, again, if this feels too much, you can always put something under your forehead or put a blanket between your tailbone and shin or even under your belly for supported child's pose. I'm gonna turn it around so I don't turn my back to you again, because my blocks are up ahead. And now from here, I'm gonna start to crawl my fingers. It's gonna pull in, and I'm gonna start to come into a kneeling salutation. As I inhale, allow the arms to go up to the sky. And as you exhale, hands to your heart. Locating where those blocks are, we're gonna use those blocks up ahead. This is coming into a low lunge. Stepping the right foot forward. As you inhale, flow here, open your heart forward. As you exhale, press into that front heel. So I'm just taking the block so you can see. Heel is up, his toes are up, and I'm starting to push my hip back. As I inhale, moving the chest forward and up. And as you exhale, pressing the heel, hips go back, and you fold over your leg. This time as you come up, stay here, and perhaps even climbing onto your thigh. Can you feel that you drop your tail a little bit more? Navel pulls in, deepening the stretch onto those quadriceps. Arms can go up, and like big cactus arms, you like bunch your cord, you pull it back, you start to shrug the shoulders down the back, open the heart, inhale, and exhale all the way down. Beautiful. I'm gonna step that foot back. And as I do, inhale, both arms are gonna go up. Kneeling salutation, exhale, hands to the heart. Hands to the blocks. This time, it's the left foot that steps forward. Inhale, open. Exhale, press into the heel, hips push back. So when you move forward, try not to let the knee pass the toes. Inhale. It's okay to pass the heel, but you don't want to push it too much beyond the toes. Push it back onto your heels, soften the knees, inhale, coming forward. Maybe here, you climb up onto your thighs, engage the core, dropping the tail, arms can go up as you inhale. And exhale, like a bungee cord, you pull the shoulder blades down the back, really feeling that opening of the heart lifting up. Really sit down, nicely done. And stepping that foot back. Take the blocks a little bit more ahead of you. And we're gonna come up. So when you feel ready, we're gonna take one foot and then the other up, tucking the toes. Take your time here. Bring your hands to your thighs. Your spine is nice and long, like you're sitting back into a stool. And then from here, press into your feet, into your thighs, and allow your arms perhaps to reach up, lift up. And as you exhale, hands to your heart. So you're coming into your Tadasana, mountain pose, and you ground through your feet. When you feel ready, inhale, allow your arms to reach up. And as you exhale, hinging from your hips, slide your hands to your thighs once again, engage your core. And I'm gonna shift the weight to my right foot, hand stays on the right thigh for support, sliding your left foot back. Press into that left heel. And when you're ready, inhale, reach your arms up, warrior one. As you exhale, open that left arm back. And you're finding your warrior two. Now, if you want to shimmy your foot a little further back, warrior two is usually a little bit longer. You can't because your hips and your chest are opening to the long side of your mat. Turn your palms up to the sky, relax your shoulders, and inhale, press into the front heel, reach your arms up. Now, as you exhale, bend into the front knee, traction the knee and toes. Knee is opening more to the pinky toe side, so don't let that knee flop in. Inhale once again, inner legs engaging like triangle legs. Hold it here and bring your left hand to your hip in this reverse triangle as you reach up and back. Exhale, bend into the front knee, reverse warrior. And as you exhale, bring your hand to the thigh, version of extended side angle. You can stay here and roll that shoulder back, maybe the forearm. Maybe the arm will go all the way up so you can find that opening through the side. Your choice. With your next exhale, release. Let the arm come back down and back. Inhale, warrior two. Now, as you exhale, look for where your blocks are at or your hands onto your thighs. And you can shift or to the blocks or to your thighs as you slide the other foot back in. Press into your feet and inhale. Take your arms all the way up. And exhale, hands to your heart. We're going to do the same flow on the other side. I'm just going to turn it around so I don't turn my back to you. And once again, from your mountain, your Tadasana, heels grounding, tail dropping, inhale, reach up, lift up. As you exhale, slowly start to hinge from your hips, shift the weight to your heels, hands come to the thighs and shift the weight to your left thigh. So both hands to the left thigh so you can slide your right foot back. Press into that heel and as you inhale, let your arms open forward and up. Front knee is bent. And as you exhale, soften, let the right hand open up, level your arms, your shoulders, warrior two. Again, if you want to shimmy that foot a little further back, you can. You can stay also a little bit higher up, up to you. Just don't let that front knee pass the toe, press into the heel. Inhale, reach up, lift up, peaceful warrior. Exhale, bend, beautiful. Inhale, lift, feel those inner legs pulling together, a lot of hips grounding here. Bring that right hand to the hip and from here, reversing that triangle. And as you exhale, bend into the front knee, reverse warrior. As you exhale, let the hand come to the thigh. And we're opening now the other side. Roll the right shoulder back. Feel the opening through the right. You can stay here and you can reach that arm up and over your head. And your extended side angle, Uttita Fasukarnasana, your choice. Again, be careful with the front knee, the hips. Let that arm pull you back. Inhale, warrior two. And as we exhale, finishing the flow, hands to the blocks or your thighs. I'm going to drop it to the block so you can see the difference. Again, it's just a matter of going a little further down than up. And you press and you lift. Inhale. And as you exhale, hands to your heart. So we're going to close here. But one more balancing and standing pose. We're gonna come to tree pose. So again, you can always use a wall for support or a chair or something close by. I'm gonna actually use one of those blocks today so you can have a feeling of how to work with the blocks if you like. I'm gonna put the blocks between my feet going to move it back here so I can get into the screen. I'm short, but sometimes I don't want to be cut too much. All right, so I'm going to shift the weight to the right, and I'm going to slide my left toes to the block, pressing that heel on the inside. So think about that's where that kidney line, imaginary line, moves from the ball of the foot up on the inseam. So from here, I'm pressing in. So try not to let your hips sway out, pull in, and you start to lengthen. Now again, you can always use the wall for support, and maybe you take your hands to your heart. Or maybe you start to let your branches grow, heart lifts, and you root down to lift up. But some of you might feel a little bit more adventurous that you want to slide that leg a little bit higher up, you can. But again, don't forget the hips sinking to the side, pull it in. And as you exhale, slowly bring the hands back down. Take your time, and we're going to shift weight to the other side. You can let it sway a little bit, and then completely shifting it over to the left, sliding the right toes up onto the block and pressing the heel. So when we start to shift the weight from one side to the other, it becomes a weight-bearing exercise. And whenever you do a weight-bearing exercise, it's like you're lifting weight. It's like you're helping to build bone mass, right? Also helps to build muscle and stability here and strength. Engage the core. Root down to lift up. And again, maybe one hand is onto that wall. Maybe your tailbone is against the wall. But can you find a little bit more lift? So you feel that you're rooting down to rise up and the heart opens. Your branches are blooming, flowering up, and you roll your wrists all the way down. And then slowly let your hips sway. I'm going to take that block back again to the front to help us return back to the mat. So whenever you're ready, as you press into your feet, inhale, allow your arms to reach up, lift up. And as you exhale, hinging from your hips, engage your core. Fingertips can come to the thighs or to your blocks as you step one knee and then the other back. And from here, allow yourself to find onto your hips. And as I have my hips here, I'm going to take my right shin slightly ahead of the left. So if you look from the side, this is what we call kind of like 90-90. Right shin is in front. Left shin is back. And this is a modified pigeon pose to get a little bit more onto the hips. So you inhale, lengthening your spine. And as you exhale, perhaps you walk your hands a little bit more forward and you lean and you hinge here. And you might feel a little bit more on the outer leg and also into the glutes. But if you have pigeon in your practice, if you want to extend that back leg completely and fold over, you can as well. Walk those hands back in. And we're going to take the hands behind and do a little windshield wiping of the knees and shins to the other side. So sometimes it takes a little bit more adjusting to get there, and that's absolutely fine. And inhale, lengthen your spine. And as you exhale, you're going to walk your hands a little bit more forward so you get, once again, a little bit more into that outer hip and glutes. And maybe on this side, you do a little sway, fine-tuning your pose. Can you feel it? You relax the head and shoulders here. Sometimes when we start to get a little deeper in the hips, the jaw kind of like locks up. There's a deeper line there connecting that connects jaw and hips. And then release, and then we're going to take it back and just doing a little sway of the hips. Any form or way that works for you, perhaps you bring the soles of the feet together, knees out to the side like we did in the beginning. This one might be good to have a blanket or blocks under your hips. And you can just let it stay out to the front. If again, it feels too much, blocks can be your friends here and you can just sneak them under your knees. So we're coming into Baddha Konasana. Supta means recline, which we were doing in the beginning. Inhale, lift. And as you exhale, maybe take your fingertips behind you so it helps with that hinge. And you feel it more on the inner legs now. Relax the head. The ones that have the flexibility of holding the ankles and hinging more, you can. With your next exhale, take your hands on the outside of your legs as it helps you to come up. And you extend and give it a little bit of a shake. Allow that left foot to come in, and you can hold onto that shin. Inhale here, and you can hold it in, and as you exhale, open twist, revolve over to the right, allowing the spine to feel nice and tall. And exhale, release, extend that leg forward, and slide the other foot in. Doesn't have to be too close, enough that you can hold onto it or use the revolving against it, right? You can choose either one, pulling in to lift or pushing against to lift, and revolve open over to the left. And exhale, release. Nicely done. And give it a little bit of a shake. And when you feel ready, we're gonna come back down to our mat. The blanket could be behind your head at the end. And if you know that you wanna have a roll blanket under your knees, just have it kind of close by so you know where it is. Allow yourself to come back down. Give your knees a hug and a gentle rock. So it's up to you if you wanna adjust that blanket under your head or not. And then from here, dropping your feet to the floor, or perhaps even onto that blanket if it's not too troublesome. And you're gonna bridge your hips slightly up. Take one of your blocks here and bring it under your sit bones. Take your elbows in and push the elbows into the floor, open into your chest. And now when you feel ready, let one leg and then the other reach up to the sky. So this is a great pose to do at the end of the day because it helps reverse the flow of the legs, right? Standing too long or staying in that same position. So now there's a little bit of cooling inversion, calming down. This pose also helps with sleep, also helps with digestion. Take a nice deep breath in. And a big sigh through the mouth. Again, one more deep breath in. Knees are soft. Body is soft. Sigh it out. And as you sigh, your knees soften into your chest. Your feet comes back down to the floor. You push down to bridge your hips enough that you can take your block from under you. And giving your knees a gentle rock side to side. Maybe hugging the backs of the knees. And or maybe even holding into the shins or to the feet for your happy baby. Your choice. There's so many variations of this. And when you're ready to release, your legs are going to extend forward. The backs of your knees finds that roll blanket. The chin is in. The palms are up, and you can cover your eyes with the eye pillow or some clothing to find a little bit more calming sensation. You can cover your body with a blanket for warmth and weight. So allowing your body to settle in for your shavasana. The muscles in the forehead relaxes, corners of the eyes. Unclenching the cheeks, the jaw, and softening your tongue. Feel the release of the back of the throat, down your shoulders, along the elbows, the wrists, the fingers to soften. And the heart is light, the belly is soft. And your hips, heavy, sinking like sand, down. The earth supports it, so you can relax through your legs, knees, ankles, and toes. Thank you. If you're happy where you are, stay where you are. You're in the comfort and safety of your home. But if you feel like moving, start to wiggle the fingers and the toes, perhaps the wrists and the ankles. Take your time. Noticing how the body feels, the mind after your practice. Perhaps with your next inhale, take a nice deep breath in, lengthening. And with the exhalation, hugging your knees into your chest, allowing the body perhaps to rock side to side. And when it feels right for you, allowing your body to roll over to the left as you use your hands to come up to your seat. The spine feel nice and tall. Letting the head rest over the heart and the heart resting over the hips. Perhaps seated on a blanket or blocks, if that helps. You're going to take your peace fingers. You can keep your eyes closed. And your peace fingers are going to root down into the earth. And if you're sitting high that your fingers don't touch the floor, you can root down into your thighs. And this is a grounding mudra, Bhu mudra. And if there's anything that's holding you back, you just feel it washing away and disappearing into the earth. And feeling for all the qualities of the earth, the support, the embrace, the well-being, the safety, the light and gratitude lifting up into your heart, shining even brighter. We're going to bring our palms together into Anjali Mudra, prayer pose, thumbs to the forehead. And together we bow, namaste. The light in me bows to the light in you. Thank you so much. I hope you enjoyed the practice. If you have any questions, doubts, feedback, please let me know. You can also send me an email whenever you need.